mailed. Delivering it now will only hurt my wife. Please.
I'm sorry, Mr. Anderson. There's really nothing I can do about it. It has to be delivered.
You don't understand. I wrote it a year ago. It'll ruin everything.
I'm truly sorry.
This gentleman has got something for you.
Now, this letter was mailed to you a year ago. A carrier plane crashed and a bag of mail from it just found. If you'll sign here, please.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. We're sorry about the delay. Very sorry.
About the post office. Either rain, snow, heat, or gloom of night could.
Elaine.
I can't complain that you didn't write me while you were in Mexico.
Why did you do that?
Who wants to read a letter that's a year old? Probably a travelogue anyway. You never were a very good letter writer.
I'll bet you one thing.
What's that, darling?
I'll never write another one.
Telephone, Mr. Childs. Your manager is on the line.
All right, I'm in. Phil? No. No, that is not good enough. I've already played Carnegie Hall. Look, Phil, I don't want to argue about it. Either arrange out a European tour or I'll get somebody else. And start with London.
I'm afraid Miss Parkington no longer lives here.
Oh. Well, do you have a forwarding address for her?
Yes, I'll write it down for you.
Okay.
Deep in Devon, England, is Gidley Park, the inn given the award for the best wine cellar in Great Britain. Its owner is an American, the wine authority Paul Henderson. Recently, he compared two California Chablis.
I compared Taylor California Cellars and Almaden Mountain Chablis, and the difference is striking. Taylor California Cellars is far better tasting. It has a crisper taste, a cleaner taste, a fresher taste. There's no question which wine I would recommend.
Taylor California Cellars, a better Chablis. Judge for yourself.
Now's the time. You've got 48 hours to save a lot of money at the spectacular Acme Rubbermaid Sale. This Monday and Tuesday only, we're selling all Rubbermaid items at half price. Imagine sinkware, gallon and half gallon pitchers, waste baskets and trash cans, bath and laundry aids too. Because it's Rubbermaid, it's all top quality. And because it's Acme, it's all half price. This sale is on Monday and Tuesday only, so get them while supplies last. The 48-hour Rubbermaid Sale at Acme, your store for low prices. Tell a friend.
The problem with bargain mufflers is they're hardly ever made just for your car. But at Midas, we stock over 800 different kinds of mufflers. So no matter what kind of car you bring in, you'll get a muffler that's right for your car. The only time we'll ever stock just one kind of muffler is when there's just one kind of car.
Trust the Midas touch.
Trust the Midas Touch at 94 convenient locations in the New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut metropolitan area.
The Royal Danish Ballet. It's one part legend and one part lightning. For this is a company of dazzling dancers and incredible contrasts. Come see the magic spell of Danish folk stories, the majestic style of Bournonville classics, and the magnificent fire of 20th century masterpieces. They're all yours from now through June 26th. Come to the Met box office or call for your tickets to the Royal Danish Ballet. At the Met.
Sorry about the foul-up in delivering this. Hope it didn't spoil anything. Would you sign here, please? Thanks, Miss Parkington.
Penelope, just a short note to let you know how happy I've been these past 3 months. It's hard to believe it's me, but I'm in love. Yes, with your Derek. I owe you so much, Penny. There's so much to repay.
Now, that's a lovely testimonial to a charitable and fine woman, but what is the point to all of this, Penelope? I'm a very busy man.
The postmark on this letter is the same day that Geraldine died.
What's that supposed to prove?
I think back to the 3 attempts I made on my life, and I thank God I was never successful. What a beautiful life it is, Penny, and what a terrible waste it would have been. Does that sound like a woman about to commit suicide? Well, does it, Derek?
Now, listen. I told the police what happened. I was up in the deck, and she was below filling us up with those drinks. And when I came down, she'd already done it. Now, what motive could I have, Penelope? I had everything. She would have given me the world if I'd asked for it.
Except what you really wanted. Derry keeps bringing up the concert tour I promised him. But I can't go through with it. Sometimes I feel the hatred so strong in his eyes, I think he might even kill me, and I'm frightened. But then he smiles, and it's all wonderful again.
Penelope, that is nothing. It's not hard proof, it's nothing.
I wonder if a second inquest would feel the same way as you do. The first time it was touch and go, do you remember, Derek? For a while there, I thought you weren't going to make it. Oh, fair enough. Why don't we let them read Geraldine's letter and decide for themselves? It's just a copy, Derek. The original is in my lawyer's safe, along with a letter from me stating that should I die suddenly, you might be considered a prime suspect.
Penelope. Please. Don't go to the police, please.
The police? Oh, no, Derek, no. Now, I'm not going to go to the police. I've waited much too long, and I have too much to make up for to let them have you. There are two things that I want from you, Derek. The first, and there'll be no further discussion about this, no more music for you. You can't afford it. And second, bring my suitcases up to our bedroom, Eric, darling.
What's wrong with her?
I don't know what's wrong with her.
Karen! She is your baby. Don't you want to take care of her?
No, Mother, I can't. Not right now. It's been happening, just like you said. Every time I look at her, all kinds of questions go through my mind. Why did he leave me? Did he love me, Mother? Did he really love me? I could live with that. I could live with her just knowing he did. But not like this.
An airmail letter from Mrs. Forrester.
Oh, I'm Mrs. Forrester.
This letter's been delayed a while. Over a year, as a matter of fact. I think I better explain.
And she deserves much more than that. So tomorrow morning, I'm going back, Mrs. Forrester. Back to where my life became dirt. Because I didn't kill that fellow, and I'm going to prove it. And if it turns out for me, and it's got to, then I'm coming back for Karen. Because I didn't love her enough. Because I did. And I still do. And if it turns out for me, then it's got to, Then I'm coming back for Karen.
I only wanted to do what was best for you. I swear that's all I wanted. Letter, but you didn't. You didn't, and I love you for it. I know what it took for you to give me that letter. But you didn't just give me a letter. You gave me Joe back. You gave me my daughter back. I love you, Mama.
In a letter, do you? Good news, bad news, you just never know. Well, we'll see that you get your mail, okay? May take us a little time, but sooner or later, you'll get your letter.
Now stay tuned for our second feature, Fools. It follows immediately on the Channel 7 Sunday Night Movies.
Thank you.
think she's hot stuff.
I knew a girl once. She didn't think she was hot stuff. She had a big brown mole on her lip, right there. And a club foot.
She had a club foot?
Yep.
How'd she get a club foot?
I don't know. There's one now.
One what?
You know what I mean. This place is full of them. Oh, come on. Well, just look around. Your name. You shouldn't encourage them. I was not encouraging them.
Children need discipline.
I was not encouraging them. All I said was hello.
I know. It's no good to indulge them like that. You have absolutely no idea how to handle children.
I'm not their father. They're not my responsibility.
Be firm.
Anywhere near that dog again, he's going to grab your arms in his teeth and rip them right off.
No, she's a good dog.
All right. What do you want to do that for?
Well, he said she was a good dog. Look, look, the one I told you about. Here she comes.
You hold the dog. He's your responsibility.
What'd you say to those kids?
Tell them your dog would rip their arms off.
You crazy or something?
Maybe.
Funny too, huh?
No.
What are you, a pervert or something?
She called him a pervert.
Yeah, he looks like a pervert.
You want to apologize to this lady?
I don't think so.
I think you do.
I think you're wrong.
You don't have any right being around children. If he doesn't apologize, I'm going to call the police.
Excuse me, folks, but I'm going to go.
Oh, no, you don't.
Oh. My God, he hit him.
So you want to fight, huh?
Thanks, fellas. Any time.
You're pretty stupid.
See what happened?
Yeah.
What would you have done?
I don't know. Maybe pet the dog.
That dog would have mangled those kids.
I was watching him. He wasn't sunning himself. He was sitting there trying to hold on to that dog.
Well, what does a man bring a dog in a park for if it makes him so nervous?
Because they look well together.
You think so?
I think they're both beautiful. So does he.
Man and his dog.
You all right?
Yeah.
Could I have my handkerchief back?
Sorry. Hey, what's your name?
Anais.
Come on. Hey, sorry. I'm sorry,
Again?
Yeah, again. My name's Matthew.
Any relation to the saint?
Faintly.
Faintly saintly.
That old guy picked her up. That's disgusting.
Hey, look, there's one of those old fortune-telling scales.
I wonder what's going to happen to me.
Well, you have to weigh yourself.
She's Cammy all over.
Cammy is the only leading beauty bar that's one half coconut soap for creamier lather to feel soft all over.
Not just the face, but every place. She's Cammy all over.
Cammy for beautiful skin all over.
Come on over to the right light, Del Monte Light.
People like it better.
Get the flavor of a bright light.
Bright light.
Del Monte Light.
More and more people are switching to light fruit, and more are deciding Del Monte Light tastes the best. No artificial flavors or sweeteners, just fresh peach taste bursting through.
Come on over to the bright light, Del Monte Light.
Love.
Say hi to Grandma. Oh,
Mom. She's such a happy baby.
And comfortable, because Josie wears Love's.
Love's hourglass design fits comfortably.
All elastic diapers don't fit the same. Compare yours to Love's. Hold it up to the light. If the padding's wide, it has to bunch up between your baby's legs. Love's padding's curve to fit comfortably.
Your baby's comfort begins with Love's.
Meineke Discount Mufflers shatters prices. Any make, any model. American cars, Japanese cars, German cars, English cars, Swedish cars, French cars, you name it.
That's right, Molly. Thousands of car owners have taken advantage of Meineke Discount Mufflers prices. So when you need a muffler, check Meineke's low prices. It's easy.
Because chances are there's a Meineke shop near your home. Drive in today.
Install from $16.93 to $24.95. Each shop individually owned and operated.
Here with a Channel 7 editorial is Cliff Love, editorial director of WABC-TV.
Governor Carey and a task force of bureaucrats have decided to convert some of the state's mental hospitals into prisons. Now, on the surface, that might sound like a good idea. Our prisons are dangerously overcrowded, and there is space available in some of our mental hospitals. The governor's decided to use three empty buildings at Pilgrim State Hospital for a minimum security prison. They will house 1,000 inmates. The first 400 are due in July. This high-handed move raises serious questions. Does it violate the safety of the residents who live nearby? Why didn't the state hold public hearings with the community before the plan was dumped on them? And should mental patients and prisoners be housed side by side? The governor claims that this plan is the only feasible way to relieve prison overcrowding. He also says it cost $100,000 to build one new prison cell and only $15,000 per cell to convert one of these underutilized facilities. But that rationale wears a little thin because of the way the governor ran roughshod over the residents of Suffolk County. These people are understandably worried about their safety. That's why the county is taking the state to court. The governor and his cohorts have a lot of explaining to do. I'm Cliff Love.
What's your opinion? Write Channel 7 Editorials, 7 Lincoln Square, New York, New York, 10023.
From the Ed Sullivan Theater in New York City, the man who brought you the laughter, the music,
the temptation,
and that little Italian mouse,
Topo Gigio.
Now the best acts of the big show are back.
Who is it?
This week, Richard Pryor.
Avon calling.
Plus,
Mamas and the Poppins.
John Viner hosts The Best of Sullivan, premiering Thursday at 7:30 on 7.
The Royal Danish Ballet. It's one part legend and one part lightning. For this is a company of dazzling dancers and incredible contrasts. Come see the magic spell of Danish folk stories, the majestic style of Bournonville classics, and the magnificent fire of 20th century masterpieces. They're all yours from now through June 26th. Come to the Met box office or call for your tickets to the Royal Danish Ballet. At the Met.
How can you tell the difference between a happy used car and a sad used car? Miles alone won't always tell.
We won't sell you a sad used car at any price. That's how.
Before you buy any used car at any price, visit one of our fussy customer stores and their big love-a-lots. You'll always find a huge selection of great used car love-a-deals, all at lovable prices. Call this area code 201 number for the fussy customer store nearest you. We just love fussy customers like you.
Me too.
We watch our P's and Q's and A and B.
Come on in. We're ready for you.
P's for prices lower than long.
The more of these you see, the more smiles I see.
Q is for quality in every store.
When you see these, you see savings.
Mm. Low prices, high quality, that's our recipe.
Beautiful.
Come on in, we'll watch our P's and Q's.
Thank you.
you're acting and when you're not acting.
That's a silly thing to say.
What's silly about it?
Just because I'm an actor doesn't mean I'm acting all the time.
Do you know when you're not acting?
When?
I'm asking you.
Well, I'm not acting now.
What are you doing?
I'm just walking and talking.
Hey, this is ridiculous.
What?
Well, you can't even walk anymore. You can't even walk to the Golden Gate Bridge.
Isn't there another road?
Machine! Machine! The whole world is infested with automobiles. What's going on? What are you doing to us? What's happening to us all? Stop it! Stop it! You're killing me!
I thought you weren't acting now.
I'm not.
What was that?
Speech.
You're funny.
I played Cyrano de Bergerac.
Really?
But mostly I did horror films.
I'll bet you were good.
Yeah.
Art.
You don't look like a woman who's wealthy.
Did I say I had a lot of money?
You said you were married to a millionaire, an attorney.